Hi, welcome to this new tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to create a bootable USB drive the easy way. So if you don't really know what does this mean, when do you need a bootable USB drive? So suppose in your laptop or in your computer you don't have a DVD drive where you can put your insert your DVD and boot from it, or for many reasons you can only do that through a USB. What you can do is that you can download an ISO copy of your operating system, then use these tools that I'm going to show you to make your USB bootable. That means that when you will insert your USB key into your computer, you will be able to boot from it. So before starting, then I assume that you know what a bootable USB drive means, and you also know what ISO copy means. So if you have these two things, let us get started. So what you can do is that if you are using Windows, if you want to install, for example, Windows 10 or any version of Windows in your computer, you will go into this, no need to use any third party tool. Go directly into this link here. I'm sure I will share with you in the descriptions under this video. You will come here, then download this tool. Microsoft have already made this tool, Windows 10 Installation Media, ready for you. You download it. After you download it, then and you will have something like this. Give the permission. It's starting up. In a while, then here is our tool coming, getting ready. Then after it's loaded, you have here, you need to accept this agreement. If you have time, you can read it, then you can just accept it. Then wait again for a while, few things ready. Then now, do you want to upgrade an existing PC? So you have Windows 7 and trying to upgrade to Windows 10, no, then you want to create the installation media. So you click the second options, then go to next. Then here you are presented with this default options here. Then by default here is taking my computer configurations. I'm using a 32 bits of Windows 10 and the language is English. So it's not the configuration that you have. What we have to do is to uncheck this one so that you can customize it according to the language that you want to install your operating system on. You select the language, here is English, then here is Windows 10, then here architecture of your computer, is it a 32-bit or a 64-bit, sorry. Which one of them do you want to install? If you want to install both of them, then you use this one boot. But suppose that you want to download a 64-bit, what we do is this one, then it is okay, then we go to next here, then you have here to select to select your USB drive. Your USB drive, and it need to be at least 8 GB. Then if you have the exo copy, you need to burn the exo copy to the DV driver. Then if you want to do it in the USB driver, then to the CD driver, then go for this one. But what we need is this one, that USB drive. Then we select that one, then go to next here. Then it cannot find the USB drive. So what I want to do is that I want to insert one USB drive. You can see a new USB drive. It's recorded now. So after you select this one, you push for this one, it will start downloading. If you just go for the next one here, here it start getting ready and downloading. So it is not what we need, so I will cancel it. Then it's worth mentioning that when you are doing this one, you should have your internet connections ready. Or if you don't have your internet connection ready, then if you don't have a suitable internet connections, there is an alternative way to do this one offline. And for this one, I will present you a second tool, that is this Rufus, that I found that is very handy. You may go for these options here, and the good news is that you can just download it. You don't even have to install it because it has these portable versions. So here is the one. I will also put the link under this video descriptions. And what you do is this one. You just have to download your ISO copy, put it in your computer. Then here you have to select your drive here, the drive that has been automatically selected. So it is the USB drive. If I remove it, it's gone. It's not there. So you have to put your USB drive. And here, depending to the size of your operating system, you may put 3 GB, 2 GB, or if these are small versions of Linux, you may have 1 GB or 2 GB or any amount of gigabyte that you have, depending to the size of the operating system. So what you will do is this one, that you insert your USB drive, select your USB drive here. And then here you come and select which version of the operating system that you want to use, right? You select Linux or React Linux or whatever you want. And if you don't, if it's Windows, you select this one, then come here and try to select where you have put your ISO copy, right? Then you put it, then here you come, you may select this one if you want, list USB hard drives, then it's not there. Then here you may, depending to what you select here, you may have some options here that will be presented to you. Then after that, bam, you click on ready. Then it will start, and after a while, like this one, if you are, suppose this is the default, this example one here, you want to install to make a bootable Ubuntu drive. Here Ubuntu is selected, the ISO copy, then the partitions, the target system, is it BIOS or UEFI? Then here volume label, you want, how do you want to name our labels? Then file system, then cluster size, then ready. And after that, bam, you have a bootable USB drive. So these are some of the two tools that you may use to create your USB drive and make it bootable. And of course, you also need to go into your BIOS. Depending to your BIOS configuration, you have to get into the boot options and try to move your USB. Here we may put up key to move it up or down. or you may use in certain operating system F5 or F6. Please read your BIOS, and you may also have stuff like this one from Lenovo, where you will have to move this USB HDD into the first position so that you may be able to boot from that one. So that is it, and I hope that this small tutorial has been useful to you. And try it and give us your comment what you think. Stay tuned. Bye.